We're outside Heinz Field in downtown Pittsburgh, home of the NFL's Pittsburgh Steelers. It's also the home of the Pittsburgh Panther football team, which will host Oklahoma State Saturday at 11 a.m. Pitt has a unique connection to OSU. Jimmy Johnson and Pat Jones, two future OSU head coaches, were assistants together at Pitt, Jimmy for 2 years, Pat for 1 year. Earlier this week, I talked to Pat after his radio talk show in Tulsa about his one season as a Pitt assistant. Pat Jones was only at Pittsburgh for one season, but his impressions of the city, the school, and the region are still vivid nearly 40 years later.
Pittsburgh is really a good town. It's very, in a general sense, hardworking. There was a lot of Western Pennsylvania kids, tough, fun to coach. I remember Jimmy telling me when he went up there, he said, these are the toughest kids in a general sense that he's ever coached.
It's the Penn State Nittany Lions versus the Pitt Panthers.
Pitt was in its prime at the time. The 1978 season was just 2 years after the Panthers had won the national championship and Tony Dorsett had won the Heisman Trophy. And the roster was filled with future stars.
I was coaching the outside linebackers at that point in time. Well, I had one guy named Hugh Green, who later almost won the Heisman Trophy, and the other one, who really was only a part-time starter, was Ricky Jackson from Pahokee, Florida. Well, he's got a bust in Canton. So, you know, but it was probably in the modern era the greatest time for Pitt football.
Not only did Pitt have talented players, but an outstanding staff to coach them. Under head coach Jackie Sherrill, Pitt had four assistants who went on to become head coaches: Foge Fazio, Dave Wanstedt, Jimmy Johnson, and Pat Jones.
And this was a pretty high-powered staff of guys, yes.
Pitt finished the regular season 7-4 with a bid to play North Carolina State in the Tangerine Bowl. But Johnson had already accepted the head coaching job at Oklahoma State, and Pat Jones was coming with him to be the Cowboys' defensive coordinator.
He had a split staff. That was a little bit funky. In all honesty, the practices were awful. We're trying to recruit down here. I'm calling kids in Oklahoma. And all I can remember was just Jimmy and I saying, as soon as we can get our gear and get off and get back to Pittsburgh and get on a plane to Stillwater, let's go.
Jones became part of a talented staff at OSU that included Wanstedt, future Dallas Cowboys assistant Tony Wise, and future college and NFL head coach Butch Davis. Jones eventually succeeded Johnson as OSU's head coach. And after a pair of really good seasons in 1984 and 85 at OSU, Jones nearly took up Pitt's offer to become the Panthers' head coach.
Had we taken the job at Pitt, see, that was the class that we recruited Gundy in. I would like to think that Mike would have come to Stillwater anyway. Now, Mike's claiming, he's told me he wouldn't. He said he'd gone to OU. I think he's just making me feel good. But, you know the ifs, what ifs about that whole scenario kind of get interesting.
You know the rest of the story. Pat stayed at Oklahoma State. Gundy came to OSU, was an outstanding quarterback, and eventually became the head coach, and now has the Cowboys ranked 9th in the country. They'll take on Pitt Saturday at 11 a.m. We'll be there to cover it for you with complete reports at 6 and 10 on Saturday evening. In Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, I'm Brian Brinkley, Oklahoma's News 4 Sports.